Hello friends, welcome to another lecture of quantity surveying and costing. In this lecture we will learn how to calculate the quantities of any road project. On screen you can see there is a road cross section diagram. In this diagram there are different types of elements which are usually used in any road. One by one I will describe you. So on the right side you can see there is a 24 feet wide road carriageway. The road carriageway is divided into two lanes. In center there is a center line, and at both ends you can see there is a curb blocks. These are called road curb blocks. And when you go from right to left you can see there is a 5 feet wide footpath. On one side of the footpath there is a road curb block, and on the other side of the footpath you can see there is an edge block. The size of edge block and curb block are also mentioned in this diagram. And after footpath you can see there is an 8 feet wide green belt of grass. Here we are calculating the road quantities for a 1000 feet long road. Here first we write right of way. Our right of way of road is 50 feet. In diagram you can see there is a 50 feet right of way which is start from one end to the other end, and at both ends you can see there is a slope of ground which is 1:2. So we write here, first of all the first item will be in road works, clearing and grubbing. This item usually not mentioned in any cross section. Here in numbers we write 1, in length we write 1000 feet road length. In width we go back to the diagram. Here you can see the road right of way is 50 feet, and at both ends you can see there is a slope of ground or a fill that is 1:2. And the height of the fill is 5 feet and the slope is 1:2. So in width we add 50 feet right of way plus the fill height into 2 for one end. Again add fill height into 2. The 2 is from slope 1:2. 1 is vertical and 2 is horizontal. The width of clearing and grubbing of the ground is 70 feet. There is no need of depth in clearing and grubbing. So now we will multiply the quantities. Here the answer is 70,000 SFT. Now the second item of the road works is NGC, that is natural ground compaction. Natural ground compaction. For natural ground compaction we use same number 1, the same road length 1000 feet. For width we use same width as for clearing and grubbing. No need of depth. In some cases, in some schedules of some countries, you can see that natural ground compaction item could be in CFT and could be in SFT. Here we are using in SFT. Multiply these quantities. The quantity of natural ground level compaction is also same as clearing and grubbing. Now, third item. The third item is earth fill or road fill. Go back to the diagram to understand the cross section of the road fill. Here you can see there is a 50 feet right of way. The fill height is 5 feet. The fill height is 5 feet, and at the both ends you can see there is a sloping ground that is 1:2 of slope. So we write here in number 1, the length of the road will remain same 1000 feet. And for width, here we right, first of all, right of way 50 plus the fill height, that is 5 feet, is to 2, that the 2 from side slope 1 is to 2, and then divide it by 2. The same repeat for the other side of the sloping ground. 5 is the fill height, multiply by 2, that is the slope, 1 vertical and 2 horizontal, and then divide it to the 2. And in depth, we write fill height, that is 5 feet. Now, multiply these quantities. The earth fill required for our road is 3 lakh CFT, that is 0.3 million CFT. The other item is for carriageway, that is 24 feet wide. Here in diagram, we can see there is a 24 feet wide carriageway. The carriageway composed of 4 different layers. At the bottom, you can see there is a granular subbase of 1 feet. And on the above of the granular subbase, you can see there is an aggregate base of 1 feet. Here, we write first item of granular subbase. The number will be 1 because of one road. The length of the road remains same 1000 feet. For width, you can see there is a 24 feet wide. So we write here 24 feet wide, and depth. Here depth of granular subbase is mentioned 1 feet. Here we write 1 feet. And then multiply all these quantities to get the answer of granular subbase. The quantity of granular subbase in 1000 feet long road of this cross section, we required 24,000 CFT quantity. The second item will be aggregate base. The aggregate base for aggregate base course, the same quantities will be used because of the thickness of aggregate base is also 1 feet. That's why the quantity of aggregate base course will also be same as granular subbase. Now for third item, here we can see the third layer of the carriageway is asphaltic base course, that is 0.25 feet. Asphaltic base course. But before asphaltic base course, you must understand there is a layer of bituminous prime coat. Here we write number 1. In length, we write 1000 feet. In width, we write 24 feet. And no need for depth in bituminous prime coat. Multiply these quantities, the answer of bituminous prime coat will be 24,000 SFT. Now the fourth item of the carriageway is asphaltic base course. On the top of the aggregate base, there is a layer of asphaltic base course, that is 0.25 feet. So we write here asphaltic base course. The number will be same as 1. The length will also remains 1000 feet. Right of way of the carriageway will also be 24 feet. Here depth was mentioned in diagram 0.25 feet. As there are 3 parameters involved, so the unit of the asphaltic base course will be CF.